We focus on crimes across the spectrum on the internet and on the dark web, with child exploitation, network intrusions, intellectual property rights investigations. Pretty much anything that is on the internet or the dark web, we will investigate it. Child exploitation was what this cybercrime center was originally founded to counter child pornographers moving from printed material onto a material that was on the internet.
So the victim identification program specifically uses technology coupled with our investigative capabilities to review, analyze, and process child exploitation images and videos, identify and rescue the victims, identify and apprehend the offenders, and identify and locate the crime scene. Through DHS S&T, we have our Child Exploitation Imagery Analytics Project, or CHEXIA, which is about facial recognition, object recognition, and textual recognition. In 2011, I started the program as just myself with an iMac and a copy of Photoshop, and in the first 6 months was able to identify and rescue 32 child victims. Today, we're five of us working victim identification in a really well-built out laboratory, and we have 26 victim identification teams spread throughout the country. As an agency, we've identified and rescued over 4,400 children since 2012.
Many times, because of the nature of the images, we don't know where that crime took place. We don't know where that child may be. But what we've learned over time is, if we focus more on identifying the victim, it almost always leads us to the offender. And that is one thing that we really strive to do, is rescue the victim, but also, as law enforcement, obviously arrest the offenders in this.
National Center for Missing and Exploited Children receives around 750,000 images and videos a week, seized by law enforcement and just domestically here in the United States. In those images and videos, we have visual text, we have faces, we've got objects, and we've got all types of and manner of things. We have to use a lot of different technologies in order to find and identify those children. Through the funding that the S&T provided, we were able to ground truth 130,000 real-world child exploitation images and videos. And what we have seen is a dramatic performance increase.
It has just been amazing, the work that's getting done through their research and development that they do with us, through the funding that has been provided. Together, we've been able to really launch and move forward a lot of very, very important projects. All of these projects not only benefit HSI and child exploitation investigations, but we see all of these projects also benefiting more and more of our programmatic areas within HSI, whether it be human trafficking, child exploitation, drug or financial crimes. I think all of the technology that we're working with S&T today on developing and fine-tuning really plays a large part in the future of HSI and our investigations as a whole.
We hope that our collaboration with science and technology is going to continue to give us newer and better technology down the road. As the criminals find ways to try and evade identification and capture, we need to use all of the tools at our disposal to stay ahead of them and to be able to stop them from preying on innocent children.
And yeah, we have to look at some really horrific stuff, but at the end, we're doing it so that we can impact a child's life to the greater good.